Hi there, I opened my DSLR. It's the D3300, as you can see. The D3300 and D3400 that came out this year looks the same, they're basically the same camera. So I'm gonna show you how it works and do all the other review on it. You know, DSLRs are great cameras to make videos and to take high definition pictures. I have a camera back here, so it's got some cables here and charger. Here, this is the box. It's a Nikon. This is a beginner DSLR, and it works amazing. I mean, it does wonders for the price. I bought it for $400, and then the D3400 sells the close price to $400 in most of the stores. Like, you can find it in some Walmarts, even Targets. You know, it's a pretty good camera to start shooting videos and taking pictures. It comes with 18-55 lens, you know, for short range. I mean, I love this camera. I mean, I got a Canon before, but you turn it. And then I got a Nikon. I think Nikons take better pictures, but for Canons, you know, the autofocus and the video option are better than the Nikons. But Nikons, I believe, you know, take like great pictures. So this is a $400 DSLR. You see, it's a beautiful camera. It's very compact, easy to carry. It's, you know, smaller than Canon DSLRs, so it's easier to hold. It's not too heavy or anything. This is the stock lens for it. And then here you can see it's a beautiful camera. You can put it on your neck and then just go to nice places, travel and take a lot of pictures, take great videos and even post them on YouTube. I have some videos that, I have a lot of videos actually on YouTube that I shot with the Nikon D3300. The picture quality and everything is great, you know. Let's get the shooting menu first. Here you can change the image quality, image size, auto distortion control, noise reduction, AF area mode. This is very important. I'll put this onto auto area AF and that works great. It's got a built-in AF assist illuminator, so if the flash is off, it's got an ender illuminator to so you never take dark pictures with this. Movie settings, I kept it on the 1080-30. It works great. You can also do 720-60 or 1080-60 as well, but 30 is fine for me. I'm shooting on high quality all the videos. So all the settings are as I want it right now. And you can even like edit your pictures right in the camera. It's got a retouch menu. You can edit them here before you upload them into your computer or online or whatever you do with them. So it's a great camera. Yeah, here you can see the lens. If you move this left or right, you can change the zoom easily. It's on 24 right now. So let's take a picture and see how it's gonna look up the outside. Like, there's a tree there. You see, you know, the colors. It was on the auto mode, but it also has a bunch of effects I'm gonna show you later. So this is a great camera, great beginner camera to take pictures. See how it's crisp and clear with, you know, great colors. You can see all the details of the tree, the branches, everything. So it takes, DSLRs take a lot better pictures than your cell phones, even, you know, iPhone or Samsung Galaxy phones. I believe most of the DSLRs beat their picture quality. You know, and it's more fun to hold the camera in your hand instead of just like you running around with your cell phone in your hand to take pictures. I mean, DSLRs are a lot easier to carry and it's more fun to take pictures or videos with them. Let me show you, also has some FX mode. You go here, you turn this to FX. Now it's on the pop mode. You usually need to like turn the flash off, because if it's a little dark it may blow the flash, so you know that makes your pictures too bright. So I always turn the flash off. See, let's see. Greens and everything, you know. So the pop mode gives a great effect for the, makes sure all the colors are a lot brighter, so it looks great like that, you know. Because the auto mode, you know, the colors are kind of bland, so I recommend you to use the pop mode. It's an FX. And to change the effects, you basically just turn this either left or right. It has photo illustration, color sketch, dark camera, miniature effect. This is a great effect to make it look like everything is miniature, like you took the picture from afar. You can also like just select one color to show in the picture. Silhouettes, high key, low key, HDR painting, easy panorama, night vision, and super vivid. Let's try the super vivid and compare the picture with the pop effect. Here, this is the super vivid, so the colors are more vivid in this picture. You see, this is the pop. It's kind of, sometimes the pop is too bright, like during the day if you take a picture with the pop effect, like you see the sky is just too bright, it's like white coming out of it. But here the super vivid mode is sometimes better in, you know, during the day, but at night the pop looks better. So let me show you here. You can like push the I button and you can change the flash. It's got ISO on auto, the AF area mode, picture size, image quality, focus mode. You can change all those here. I love this camera, you know, I've been taking pictures with it. It's a beautiful camera, you can see. So if you want to make like videos with this Nikon D3300 or the D3400, they basically the same camera. So I'm going to show you how to shoot a video with it. Let's just turn it to the auto mode. Here, and then if you turn it around, you can see there's a no flash mode, portrait mode, landscape, and a moving mode for like take kids pictures or running people. The macro mode to take closer shots of flowers or plants, things like that. Night mode and effects. And guide mode gives you some instructions on how to use the camera. Like if you don't know what you're doing with it, you can turn to the guide mode and it gives you instructions on how to take pictures or videos. So it's in auto now. I'm gonna show you how to shoot video with it. To shoot video, you first turn the camera on, make sure your lens is, you know, open. And then there's a button here, it says LV on it. You push that once and it goes to the video mode. Here you go. And then here you push this button a little bit for a few seconds and it's gonna manually focus to the scene. Here there's a squirrel there, you can see that on the right. And then when you push the red button, it starts recording. And you can see the REC sign on the left corner. Blinking, that means it's recording right now. The video quality is amazing, this camera. And you can also like record with the effect mode, like super vivid or pop or any other, you can record it with that. And that gives some effects to your videos right off the bat. And then push the red button again on top here. And then push the LV. And then that turns off your video mode. And in order to watch your video, you go here, push the button on the top left corner. And push OK to play. Here you can watch your video before you upload it. See, the image quality is great. I think Nikon cameras are great competitors to Canons. Even some Nikon cameras are better than Canons, in my opinion. Only thing this camera is missing is the flip screen, but the like D5600, the upper models have that, so if you pay a couple hundred bucks or more, you get the flip screen with it, so you can also do selfie videos with it. Well, I guess that's about it. Thank you.